All right, for this week's project, we're going to return to the exciting world of video. I know these projects are extremely popular on my channel, since only about a quarter of the people subscribe even pays attention to these, but we're gonna do this. This is a 13-inch Montgomery Ward's color television, trash picked, right out of somebody's garbage with a remote control sitting on top of it. It's been raining here for a little bit on and off, so it did get wet. Don't know what we're gonna find out about it, but we're definitely gonna have a look at it. And while I was at my friend's shop, I went ahead and grabbed one of his leader pattern generators. He's got a couple of these laying around collecting dust. I cleaned this one off, and I'm gonna hang on to this here in case I need it for future things. But of course, everything being digital now, all of his test equipment that he has is geared towards that. And these things were just sitting around under benches gathering dust. So pulled one of those. We've got the TV. Don't know anything about it. Maybe it works, maybe it don't. It definitely got wet, so that's, you know, not a good sign right off the get-go, but we're gonna see what we can find out about it, have a look at it, see who made it for them. I mean, from the front of it, it kind of looks Samsung-ish, Sanyo-ish maybe. I don't know who made it, but we'll get it opened up and we'll find out. So give me a minute, we'll come back and we'll get started on this one. Pick back up, having a look at the back of the unit. Gonna find some useful information here. Model number JSJ12219, followed by manufacturer's date of October 1988. So definitely going back quite a few years here, and made in Malaysia. Moving on from that, going over here, and my theory about Samsung or Sanyo being the manufacturer is shot down. This is made by Sharp CRT. And we have numerous branded Sharp ICs in the unit, whether it be video processing or microprocessor or sound IF. Quite a few of these have the Sharp badge on them, so definitely think we got a Sharp set. And thinking back to back in this time frame for all those Sharp or all those Montgomery Ward's VCRs, those were all, if not nearly all, made by Sharp. And for a set that was out in the rain, and it was out in the rain, it was raining the day I took it, I don't see a lot of water or dirt on the circuit board that would be an indicator that a lot of water got into it. There is some rust on the tuner, but other than that, I don't see a lot of water, a lot of water damage. The TV doesn't have a ton of vent holes in it, so that may have played into it, but it definitely was wet the day I took it. Coming over to this side, primary side of the power supply, this one has an SCR right in the front end. And of course we have IHVT. And I do remember these being heat heavy right in this area here. Remember changing a few of those resistors back in the day. I remember right. As for the front of it, this one uses a type of keypad assembly that's basically just a remote control. It has one of those rubber mats behind it. I believe it does anyway, because none of these have a tactile feel to them, and none of them feel very good at all. Like, they're not doing anything, so I don't know if it's broke or what. The power switch is pushed in, so we're definitely not going to get any love there trying to fire it up from that switch. Now, we did get a remote control. This took on some water, no question about that. There's some corrosion in the battery compartment. So we'll have to see if we can maybe utilize this. So I think the first thing I want to do is see if I can get that remote control to work and see if we can fire it up that way and see if it'll turn on for us. So give me a minute for that and we'll come back. Well, I think let's open this remote up and see if we can determine if it's salvageable, if it's just cleaning it up and getting the battery terminals cleaned up, then we'll use this to turn it on. Ooh, something sticky. Not much to them. Little crystal resonator, a C2120 transistor, and of course an IC. Other than that though, ooh, that is nice and gooey. Look at all that. This looks like it might be fixable though. I think we'll clean it up. I'm gonna use a little Windex on this board and see if I can get this off. There's an awful lot of goo here that's not water. I don't know, had pop spilled on it or what. I remember cleaning up quite a few remote controls from back in the day. Now you can get a universal at the freaking dollar store for a few bucks, but back in the day, if you lost your remote control, you had to buy a whole new one. Wasn't an easy way to just pick up a different one. So, now let's dry that a little bit. And we'll file that off since we got a good look at it. Like that should be okay. Enough to get us some power there and get it working. Quite a bit of battery corrosion caked around here. Should do it. Doesn't look like there's anything on the spring, so now it'll be this nasty thing. You can tell there's some pop or something that's been on this. Probably the best thing to do with it would be to soak it in some warm soapy water, but we're just trying to get it to the point where it'll fire the setup. If it was something I was planning on keeping, then we'd go the extra mile, but we really just want to get it to the point where it'll turn the TV on, if the TV will even turn on. It's probably a reason it was in the garbage. And let's see, 1988. 13-inch color TV, remote control. What do you think? $250? You know? Maybe $175, $180 on sale. Still very costly. And again, that should be good enough. Boy, that is nasty. No question. There's shit coming off of that, falling all over my freaking hands. I guess we could attempt to wipe it out. Yeah, that is really nasty. Don't know what that is, but it's sticky and would need a very thorough cleaning versus what I'm doing, which is just putting a Band-Aid on it. It's even nasty up inside there. All right, let's see. I guess we'll find out. So sticky. That's probably good enough to get a battery to work in. Ooh. Oh, geez. Feels like there's something kind of restricting it right there. Yeah, there is. There's a broken tab, so we'll get that out of the way. And we'll snap it back together. Alright, I'm going to throw the camera in the tripod and hook the TV up, find some batteries for this, and we'll see if we can get a first fire. Alright, picking back up. I did get batteries in the remote control, and firing it at the TV, pushing power, does nothing. We have a dead set. I did use, this is a little card that will react to the IR coming out of the remote. You can't see it on camera, but it'll flash orange. And the remote control is outputting, but yet we don't have anything happening over here. So I'm not sure. I think we wanted to check through the power supply real quick and see if we have anything open or what voltages are there and what voltages are not. So let me get set up for that shot and we'll have a look at the power supply real quick. All right, we're going to pick back up, and this is what I've done so far. Just kind of went through this portion of the power supply, the resistors, looking for anything that might be open. Did confirm that we do have some voltage coming in. They will drop that 120 volts down to a smaller voltage because we still need 5 volts at the microprocessor before we can turn on the deflection circuits and so forth. Now, one thing I found interesting is I took this out because I wanted to make sure that that broken button wasn't doing anything that would be holding a line low to where it wouldn't turn on. And I didn't find any kind of issue there at all. But one thing I did find is that we want that 5-volt turn on, and we have it. It's there. There's no issue at all with that. And I even fixed that power button while I was in there, melted that back together so we could try it with the actual power switch just to determine if the remote control did have something funky on it. The resonator wasn't working right or something like that, but it is definitely not turning on. But I did go back and look right here, and of course I don't have a service manual, but I can kind of gauge from the location of these capacitors right here that these are probably quite critical to the circuit working. And both of these are completely open, so I think the next thing I want to do is I want to change both of those out and see if we can get this thing to fire. Other than that, I don't see anything else. Check the HOT, everything's fine there. There's no short. Again, I don't see anything burn up, so I'm gonna have to think that we've just got something that is dead from age. So I'm gonna change those two caps out, and then we're gonna come back and see if we can get this thing to fire up. All right, we're gonna pick back up with a screen full of snowy raster and a TV that is turning on. And this is going to be the culprit for that. We have two caps here. One is 100 mic at 35 volt, and the other one 47 at 16. Both of these in the relay drive circuit, tracing back where they're connected to on the foil side of the board, all leading in and around the relay drive, the coil. So, of course, if we don't have proper filterization there for the proper voltage around on across the coil, then when it's time for the set to drop one side of that to ground, it won't do it. So that's going to be the issue with that. But I am not sure what is going on. I don't have any sound, and I don't think that this thing was modern enough to just mute the snow. I would have thought it would have been blasting out, but I don't know that for a fact. So I'm going to take a second here. I'm going to hook up the pattern generator to it, and we'll see if we can get some noise through this thing. Give me a second for that, and we'll be back. Coming back in, and we're going to fire it up using the remote control. And we do have some noise. And surprisingly enough, a fairly great picture. I mean, we're going to take a look at this. I mean, just vivid, on point. And if we kill the color, grayscale, doesn't look that bad. I mean, for the age of the TV, I was blown away by this. So it's either had a really, really easy life, or Sharp made a hell of a small CRT back in the day. Look at this. Boom. Boom. Green, that green's a little weak. We could probably tweak it up, but man, that looks good. That is not bad at all. Damn, that is just banging. So, I don't know. Looks pretty good. This thing outputs on channel 5 or channel 6, which is very bizarre to me, but other than that, it's looking pretty good. We do have some really dirty, really touchy controls, though. No doubt about that. And look at that. That is so nice looking, man. Very nice looking TV. So, at this point, I think we need to find something to hook up to it. I do have a VCR in my car, and I think we need to hook that up and actually play some material through this and see what it looks like. But for the most part, there is no setup required of this. I mean, the focus, yeah, you know, maybe tweak the focus a little bit, but damn, that looks good. Can't beat it. All right, we'll find something to hook up to it, get some source material playing through it. I'm gonna clean the screen off, and we'll wrap this up. We'll do a quick play test on it with something and wrap it up. But man, for 1988, tube is in excellent condition. Can think of anything, nothing that seems more appropriate to play on this 1988 television than this VHS copy of Yes, 9012 Live. Of course, this would have been made after their unbelievably successful 90125 album. And the picture on this thing, amazing looking. Looks beautiful. Bright, vivid color. Nothing washed out, excellent contrast, excellent brightness, everything. So, if you're a fan of the video stuff, then I guess this was for you. If you happen to have one of these TVs and it won't turn on, you might want to check out the two capacitors in the power supply, 100 mic at 35 volt and 47 mic at 16. And might just get you back up and going. So, next week we'll return to audio projects and say goodbye to the video for a while. But thank you guys for watching, and we'll catch you next week. Say you don't want a chance. You've been hurt so bad.